MEP designer, you often receive the model from the architect as a DWG or as a PDF file. And if you want to work in Revit, you're faced with the challenge of starting your design on these file formats. This is why we implemented easy architectural functions to quickly create a thermal Revit model in order to start with your building analyze and MEP design. To demonstrate these functions, we start in a floor plan in an empty Revit project and first link the architect's DWG. As mentioned, this also worked with linked PDF files. Our example is an office building with connected workshop area. The workshop part is a one-story building with a ceiling height of 5 meters, and the office part has 3 floors with a ceiling height of 3 meters each. In this video, we are going to create the first floor as a Revit model, which can then serve us as a basis for our further tasks, for example, a heating load calculation. First, I create 2 building parts, namely the workshop and the office. Now I can assign different floor heights to these building parts. To do this, I first create the first floor of the workshop with a ceiling height of 5 meters, and then the floors of the office part with a height of 3 meters each, and name them accordingly. Within this story table, we then have already taken the split levels into account. Now we can start with the construction of the walls. We start with the exterior walls. With the button Get Dimensions, I can pick the thickness of the walls directly from the DWG. Now the wall thickness is set automatically and I specify the wall as an exterior wall by using the checkbox. Afterwards, I start with the construction. Because of the different story heights, I must pay attention to set the top constraint on the suitable level. In the workshop, this is the level ceiling workshop with a height of 5 meters. The link DWG now helps me to choose the appropriate snap points, and so I can very quickly and easily reconstruct the outer walls of the workshop. For the office part of the building, I now set the appropriate level to up to level second floor office to also get the correct ceiling height and create the exterior walls. If we now switch to a 3D view, we can already see the just constructed walls with the appropriate heights. I now proceed in the same way with the interior walls. I again take the wall thickness from the linked file, remove the check mark from exterior wall, and for example, construct the walls of the sanitary area. You can now do this for all interior wall, but as this would take too much time now, I've already prepared it. As you can see in this model, all walls are already included and I can continue with the windows. Let's assume that all windows in this project have a parapet height of 1 meter. Of course, you could always adjust this value here as well. In our example, we have 2 different window heights. One, the large window with 1.51 meters, as well as smaller windows with 70 centimeters high in the sanitary areas. I set the desired height, and then I can grab the window width again directly from the DWG and integrate the windows. The windows are completely generic Revit families, and so they can be used flexibly for all kinds of windows. I changed the height for the sanitary windows and also picked the window width from our linked file. Let's again have a look in a 3D view. You can already see how easy and quick this is. I also did this once for all the windows in advance, so I'm switching project to continue with the doors. For the doors, you can specify the height and also a door sill if necessary. Additionally, you can activate this checkbox if you want to install a double door. Just as with the windows, you now pick the position and widths and specify an open direction for the door. We will also do this here for a couple of doors in our example. I will switch one last time to a prepared project in which this step is already done and move on with the last component we want to add, the floor. Our building does not have a basement, which is why the floor on this first floor is an exterior component. I can specify this here via the checkbox. You can also specify the thickness directly in the command. Now I select the exterior walls, confirm the area, that's it. The floor is integrated as well. Let's have a check in the 3D view. I can now hide the DWG once to see what we've done so far. As you can see, the first floor is completed, and analogously, you could now do this for the remaining floors in the office part. In the end, you will receive an architectural model in almost no time to realize the thermal analysis, for example. Finally, I will integrate the MEP spaces by using the automatic create space command. All rooms are correctly detected and the MEP spaces are placed as desired. If you want to, you can now add further information to the spaces and move on with the building analysis and continue with your MEP design. That's workflow instead of workaround.